Hello, welcome. Thanks for joining me. My name is Shantae Tutt with Tutt Scrapbooking, and today I am going to show you all how to use the second generation rock and roll technique. And this is what the finished product should look like when you're finished. Your image should look like when you're done. So it gives it a weathered look, a little vintage rustic look. It's a cool technique. And what you'll need is some scrap paper, which I have here. You'll need two ink colors. Today I'm using cranberry and holiday red from Close to My Heart. And you need to make sure you choose two coordinating colors, okay? And then of course your image of choice, which image you would like to use on your project. And so let's begin. This foam here that I'm going to be stamping on top of, it comes when you order stamp sets from Close to My Heart, and it just helps with the image. If you stamp over top of this, it helps the image to appear and come out more crisp and clean looking. So let's begin. This is the stamp that I'm going to use today. So the very first thing you want to do is stamp your image on the first color of your choice. Now I'm going to use the lighter color, which is the holiday red. And so I'm just going to put ink on this. Ink up my stamp. First step, very simple. This is a very cool technique. I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, so now that I have ink on here, I'm just going to get some scrap paper and then stamp the scrap paper like so. Okay, and then set that aside. It's okay if all of the ink does not come off when I stamp that. That's just the scrap paper right there, okay? So you do not want to clean the stamp after you stamp it onto the scrap paper, okay? Then you're going to take your coordinating ink, which is cranberry today, and you're going to rock and roll it, your image over the ink pad, okay? Just like this. So I'm going to make sure that I do about half an inch or inch around the whole image here, just so when I restamp it that the image will come out clear, okay? So real quick, before I do that, I almost skipped a step. You're going to go ahead and stamp on the project that you're making. So this one, of course, is not going to show up as clear. It's going to be like a little shadow, and that's okay. You see how it's a little darker right there? That is all right. So now I'm going to rock and roll my stamping image over this cranberry ink color, again, which is the darker color. Just like so, very firmly going around the whole stamp. Now it's up to you. You can get creative. You don't have to go around the whole stamp like I'm doing. You can just do the corners. You can just do the top and the bottom. It's up to you. It's your project. Okay. So I'm almost done here. Let's see. And hopefully you can see that. See, I'm just kind of going around and rolling it. So once that's done, I'm just going to set that aside, and then I'm just going to restamp over the image. Press firmly. Lift, and this is what you get. Isn't that cool? I love this technique. A lot of my projects I do have a vintage look to them, and a little rustic look. I love this technique. It gives it a little weathered look, adds a little dimension to your project. So hopefully you all can use this technique, and this video was helpful for you all. Thank you for viewing. Please follow me, subscribe. Here are my Twitter, Instagram account. You can also watch me live on Periscope. Sometimes I will take my Periscope videos and start uploading them to my YouTube account so you all can see those videos as well. Those are my live videos, so you will see me stopping while I'm making a project and showing you all the tips and techniques and commenting with those who are viewing live with me. And so please, thank you for joining me. Please follow me. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.